Check one, check two. Check, check. You have a little bit more body, Chad. All right, good evening, as everyone takes their seat. You know, we're glad COVID is over, because now we get to get back together, and it's been a while since we've been able to do this. But for those of you who don't know, I am Robert Jones, currently serving as president of the Greater Texarkana branch of the NAACP. And we're so thrilled to be here this year. Last year, we did a banquet, and it was virtual, but because of you, it was successful. So we have found out that if you're willing to try different things, good things will happen. But nothing beats us all coming together like we are this year. And we are thoroughly pleased that Texarkana College was available and offered it up, and just look around. It is outstanding here tonight. But none of this would be possible without you. You need to be aware of the fact that branches of the NAACP only have two ways of raising money. That's by membership and by a Freedom Fund bank. So we only do this one time a year, and the amount of funds that come in turns out to be limited. But I want you to know that we get complaints and concern every day. And 95% of these folks were calling us aren't even members. And it's really interesting. People need to understand that this is a volunteer organization. Nobody gets paid. We don't have a staff of lawyers, but we are concerned about you. But our power comes from numbers. It's not about money, it's about numbers. And if you want to have a successful and powerful branch, you need to become members. People are always asking, what is it that the NAACP is doing? My response back to them is, what are you doing? Because we can do no more than you can do. And so, now I'm off my little soapbox. We're going to get ahead on this program. Tonight, I'm getting ready to turn it over to a colleague of mine. He's an educator, a mentor, a leader, a motivational speaker, and he comes to Texarkana all the way from California. He is Mr. Lee Williams III, and he's currently the Executive Director of Student Success, Retention, and TRIO EOC here at Texarkana College. Lee's been here since 2012, and when he got here, he started shaking things up. And he's still shaking things up. And give him a couple more years, everyone in Texarkana will know who he is. So without any further ado, I would like to now turn it over to the Master of Ceremonies tonight. So let's give it up for Mr. Lee Williams III.
Me and Mr. Jones are going to be like best friends after tonight, because we're like that close. But thank you, Mr. Jones, for that wonderful introduction. You guys look nice in this room tonight. Isn't it nice to be back out in public? Yeah. Amen. So happy that you're here tonight, both in person, and I know we have people watching virtually as well. We have not been in this same space since 2019. And again, thank you to Professor Robert Jones, Chapter President, and our Banquet Chair, Mrs. Melva Flowers, for this opportunity. Now, I gotta be honest with everybody. I've never done this before. Never done this before. I told Ms. Melva that I think yesterday, and I knew you guys wouldn't believe me. Knew you wouldn't believe me. And so I actually have a vlog, thought it would be fun to show about a 5-minute vlog of me preparing to get ready for this day here. All right? Is that okay? Five minutes. So if we could, Chad, if you could go ahead and play the video, Chad.
dangerous.
Yes, it was, indeed.
Okay, let me catch up on some emails. September 8th, 2022. Dear Mr. Williams, the Greater Texarkana Branch of the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People, NAACP, is honored that you have agreed to be the Masters of Ceremony at our 2022 Freedom Fund Awards Banquet. What was I thinking? Okay, calm down, Lee. The banquet will be held on Saturday, October 29th, 2022 at the Truman Arnold Student Center, Texarkana College, 6 p.m. The theme is This is Power. This sure is power. I've never been a master of ceremonies before, let alone what am I going to say? Wait, no. What am I going to wear? Is my suit still able to fit me? Oh my goodness, I have so much to prepare for, and it's only September.
Suit still fits. Hey Simba, suit still fits. Now, what do I say? Good evening, welcome to the 2022 Freedom Fund Banquet. No. Okay, good evening. I'm Lee Williams, welcome. Good evening, and no. Man, I gotta practice what I'm gonna say.
Yo, please drop.
Julian, did I tell you that I'm hosting the NAACP Freedom Fund Awards Banquet on October 29th?
No, man, I heard
it. No, really?
Yeah.
Well, I am.
Okay. Congratulations, man.
Appreciate it. You think this haircut will last until October 29th?
To the 29th? I doubt the 29th.
Shit.
Order is picked up. Wilson's on the move.
You actually got an appointment on the 29th at 12:30, man.
Touchdown, Seahawks. Day before.
You get me out on time?
How you out on time, or how you looking better than that?
Thank you so much.
No problem.
Yeah, like what you've done with your place, your shop, and all that kind of good stuff. Hey, you know I'm hosting the NAACP Freedom Fund Banquet on October 29th. You think this car wash is going to last until me? You know, I want to roll up in style.
It might last, but I'll be open on the 29th. So.
That's right, you are. So you're open Saturdays from 10 to 2,
yes, sir.
And then Tuesday through Friday, 9 to 5.
Yes, sir.
Bet. We appreciate you. Black-owned business here, True Wash. Definitely appreciate the wash.
Yes, sir.
Hey, Erin.
Hey.
How's it going?
It's going good.
Yeah, I got something to tell you.
Okay.
On October 29th, I'm hosting the NAACP Freedom Fund Banquet here in the Truman Arnold Student Center.
You're hosting it?
I am hosting it.
Wow.
Erin, do you mind putting up the camera in the great room in the Truman Arnold Student Center? Because I just am concerned about this event and the setup and everything being ready in time. I mean, look, Erin, there's only 6 tables in there, and this thing is supposed to have 200 people. Cameron's in there practicing. Do you think the room is going to be ready in time for this big event?
Well, it's not till next week. We'll get it set up. I promise you. I promise. Don't be nervous. It's going to be so good. You're going to be great. Don't worry.
Thanks, Aaron. Appreciate you.
through it. Special thanks to Chad Moore for putting that together for us. Also to my barber of 9 years, Julian, who is a TC graduate. My car stylist, Cortez, and then Aaron from Facilities. They do an amazing job getting all of these different events together that we have on campus. Julian and Cortez are also available if men need your haircut, women as well, and if you want your hand car wash, he can do that as well. Definitely wanting to support them, young brothers, entrepreneurs, all that kind of good stuff. So, hey, listen, can we make this a safe space tonight? Can we strive to enjoy the company of each other while being thankful for the blessing of an in-person event? Each person in this space tonight is important and you matter. Each person under the sound of my voice, or in here and virtually, you're a leader. And leadership is not just defined by title. Remember, we have power in our vote, we have power in our voice, we have power in our story, we have power even in our resources and money. We have power in our relationships, we have power in our service to this community. And so tonight, we're gonna celebrate through meaningful conversation at our tables, recognition of some outstanding leaders in our community that do amazing work. We'll have a special presentation from the top teams. I hear Cameron Smith on the saxophone, him and Susan have arrived, so they'll be here. Then we'll have a keynote address from Arkansas State Senator Linda Chesterfield, who Ms. Chesterfield has already started talking to me, and I'm excited to hear all that she's gonna talk to you guys about tonight as well. And remember, power also comes with us reaffirming our commitment to the NAACP mission that seeks to achieve equity, political rights, and social inclusion by advancing policies and practices that expand human and civil rights. It eliminates discrimination, and it accelerates the well-being, education, and economic security of Black people and all persons of color. That's the mission. And so, by now, you know, I can't hide the fact that I'm so excited to be leading us on this journey for the next couple of hours tonight. Because you guys all look great. And remember, we're going to be all learning lessons tonight as we go through this program. So, without any further ado, and I think we are on schedule. Yes, yes, yes. Now, to officially get us started, we are going to have a greeting from our mayor, Mr. Bob Brueggemann, and followed by our invocation from Reverend Dr. R.E. Ruffin, who is on stage as well. So Mayor, if you come forward right now, and we'll hear from you, followed by Reverend Dr. Ruffin, who will invocate us. Mr. Mayor.
Well, good evening, everyone. It's great to see you at this great event. Isn't it good just to be able to get out and about?
I know.
We were so cooped up for so long, and so it's just great to get out and visit and see what all is going on. And I just want to thank you for the opportunity to be with you this evening. I have several of my council members here, and I know that they'll be recognized later in the program. Councilmember Hart will be receiving an award this evening. Councilmember Hart, congratulations on your ward, on your award and your ward, as far as the work that you do within Ward 2. We commend you for that. I just want to let you all know that I bring greetings on behalf of the City of Texarkana, Texas, and I want to commend the work that the local chapter of the NAACP does here in Texarkana, USA. And also, your president, Professor Jones, and I have had a long-time relationship for many, many years, and I think it's great to have a situation where if Professor Jones, who serves as the president of this organization, has a question or he has a concern or needs to visit about a matter, that he can pick up the phone or send me an email and vice versa. And so I think it's so important to have two-way communication dealing with our community and matters that need to be addressed. And so, Professor Jones, thank you for the great work that you do, not only with the NAACP, but the many years of service here at Texarkana College. We appreciate that very much. And once again, thank you for allowing me to be here this evening. It's a great honor to be here along with my council members, and I certainly hope that you enjoy the remainder of the program. Thank you very much.
If you would bow with me. Now unto God that is able
Now, unto God that is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise God, our Savior, be glory, majesty, dominion, and power, both now and forever. Father God, we are grateful and we are thankful for this organization known as the NAACP. We are thankful for the leadership, the laborers, the supporters, those near and far. And then, oh God, we are praying for the speaker who will remind us, who will refresh us, who will renew us of just how far you have brought us. Asking, oh God, for your mercy for this nation. And we are thankful for the food that you have provided and asking for your blessings on the hand that prepared it for the nourishment of our bodies. And then, oh Lord, we'll always be learning more about you and your will. So, Father, we pray that you will give us the wisdom, give us the understanding of your word that we may help us to learn to live more in your will. We rejoice in your goodness, and we rejoice in your favor. In the precious and holy name of Jesus the Christ, we ask it all. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Dr. Ruffin. We are now going to sing the Negro National Anthem. And Cameron, are you? Okay. So let me introduce Cameron because he's going to be our music for the evening. And so I'm pleased to introduce Mr. Cameron Smith, who with the help of his saxophone, Susan, right? Yeah. Will provide us with our instrumental sound for the evening. Cameron is a student here at Texarkana College, and he's an active member of the Black Student Association and Achieving Completion Through Innovation, Vision, and Team Engagement, which is a new program that we started at Texarkana College. The parentheses mean activate. And so without any further ado, if you go to page 7 of your program, that is where the Negro National Anthem is. Can we all stand? She's really been slaving over hard teaching, and I'm excited. So dinner is served, Cameron's gonna continue to play some music, and we hope you enjoy the table conversation. And we'll be back in a few minutes. Somebody left their glasses at table 8. Anybody? Oh, the Zegers. Oh, Sister Rice. You know the. Oh. Oh, they're. Oh, this one here. Okay. Oh wait. Oh, Joey. Oh, is this you? Not your. Okay, you got yours. Okay. Oh, this is yours, Harry. Oh, wow. Well, how can you see what you're doing? All right. Hold on. Let me go take me.
my God, it's burning. But all right. And then we go to bed with y'all. Y'all over here, table 22.
What? A lot of the table.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Congratulations. Give it up for Cameron. And we're gonna play some music and enjoy your meal.
Thank you. Thank you.
joins your meal. But we're gonna go ahead and kind of get this started back up. Hey, Chad. All right, all, we're back. So I know there's a couple of folks that are still waiting for food, and we'll get that out as soon as humanly possible. But I want to go ahead and introduce the head table first. Okay. And we'll start with, I guess, my right, your left, on this side right over here, Dr. Craig and Zoe Nakashian are here. Miss Brenda Kelly. Is it doctor? No, oh, Mr. Henry. Oh, you're doctor. Okay. Because when you don't, you know, like, people are doctor and you guys know how that goes. So I'm just trying to make it to my car and get home. So please. Amen. Okay. So this is Mr. Henry Chesterfield. Here. Arkansas State Senator Linda Chesterfield. Professor President Mr. Robert Jones. Mr. President. And then Mrs. Melva Flowers, Banquet Chair. And then I have Reverend Dr. and Mrs. R.E. Ruffin. All right. We now have a special presentation from the top teams. They will come forward now. Mr. Jones, I think they need you for this presentation. This is your presentation.
Good evening. My name is Team Brooklyn Henderson, and I'm the Twin City Chapter of Top Teams of America President. With me is Team Quentin Kennedy, our Chapter Vice President, and Team Blaze Cox, our Chaplain. If there are any members of the Twin City Chapters of Top Ladies of Distinction or Top Teams, will you please stand? On behalf of the TLOD President, Mrs. Barbara Larry, and the TTA Advisor, Lady Sheila Dukes, I greet you and am honored to stand before you. TLOD has many focuses, but its main focus is Top Teens of America. Our organization supports NAACP, and all ladies and teens are encouraged to become a member and participate with the NAACP. Tonight, I want to present a check for membership of our most recently inducted Top Teens, as well as renewal for our teens who are currently members. I would like to thank the member of Greater Texarkana, Texas branch of the NAACP for your encouragement and support. I would like to extend a special thanks to Mr. Robert Jones, Dr. Charles Fontberry, Ms. Melva Flowers, Mrs. Cassandra Rohn, and Mr. Anthony Rohn. Thank you.
Jones is keeping the check, so make sure they knew that. Yes. All right. Well. All right. So now, please help me welcome Ms. Brenda Kelly, who will introduce tonight's speaker.
Represents District 30, which includes part of Pulaski County,
on both the south and north sides of the Arkansas River. She was elected to the Senate in November 2010 and sworn in January 2011. Senator Chesterfield is an assistant pro tempore for the 2nd Congressional District and vice chair of the Joint Committee on Public Retirement and Social Security Systems. Senator Chesterfield is a member of the Senate Committee on Education, the Committee on Transportation, Technology, and Legislative Affairs, the Efficiency Committee, and the Joint Budget Committee. She is a member of the Arkansas Legislative Council and Legislators Joint Auditing Committee and serves on several subcommittees. A native of Hope, Arkansas, Senator Chesterfield is the daughter of the late Ernestine Pondexter and the granddaughter of the late Miss Ophelia Logan. She was an undergraduate of Henry Clay Yerger High School, class of 1965. She was the first African American to graduate from Hendricks College in Conway. Senator Chesterfield earned her MSE from Ouachita Baptist University. She and her husband, Emery, own a consulting firm, Pondexter Chesterfield Consulting. Senator Chesterfield and her husband are members of the First Missionary Baptist Church of Greater Little Rock, where she serves as the chair of the Mission Society and is a member of the Deaconess Board. Senator Chesterfield, I like this part. She didn't know I was gonna do this. Senator Chesterfield is an active member of the Beta Pi chapter of Alpha, Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated in Little Rock, Arkansas. At this time, will all members of the local Kappa Zeta Omega chapter of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority please stand? Senator Chesterfield, on behalf of our local grad chapter, Kappa Zeta Omega chapter here in Texarkana, our president is Ms. Lakia Jones. We want to present to you this gift of sisterly love. Thank you so much.
It must be borne in mind. It must be borne in mind that the tragedy in life does not lie in failing to reach your goal. The tragedy lies in having no goal to reach. It is not a calamity to die with dreams unfulfilled. Oh, but it is a calamity not to dream. It is not a disaster to fail to capture your idea. Oh, but it is a disaster to have no idea to catch it. It is not a disgrace to fail to reach the stars. Oh, but it is a disgrace to have no star to reach for. Not failure, but low aim is sin. And we are here this evening because the members of the NAACP of Texarkana have always aimed high. Good evening. It is an honor to be with you.
Good evening.
I want to thank my wonderful sister for her gracious introduction, Sister Melva Flowers for the invitation, my illustrious homeboy, Robert Jones, Professor Robert Jones, for allowing me to be here. I want to thank our very gracious master of ceremonies. Hasn't he done a fantastic job? And just a few more points of personal privilege, and then I'll be sitting down probably. My big brother's in the house, Mr. Ricky Pondexter. Stand up, show my cute brother. He drove Hot Springs to be here, so he's a little tired. And last but certainly not least is the love of my life, Mr. Henry J. Our theme for this evening is, this is power. This is power. And our subject very simply is wake up. It's action time. Wake up. It's action time. As this country stood on the precipice between success and failure in its attempt, I'm an old social studies teacher, so just bear with me. To break away from the British, they discovered that the cost of freedom was steep. It challenged the myths of masculinity that are born of the idea that because I am who I am, I should always win. That is not always the case. Ask Vladimir Putin right now. They had to contend with those who thought disengagement from the British was both disloyal and seditious and just plain a bad idea. And so many of them, when the price of humanity got a little bit rough, wanted to just give it up. But every time things get rough in this country, and they are rough right now, there comes along a man like Thomas Paine, who was, in other parts of his life, a real pain. But we won't talk about that lesson. He said very simply, these are the times that try to insult us. The summer soldier and the sunshine patriot will, in this crisis, shrink from the service of their country. But he that stands it now will deserve the love and thanks of man and woman. Wake up. It's action time. We are living in dangerous times. We are living in a period of ignorance of government, disregard for civility, and a lack of understanding of each other that is once again trying to tear at the strings that has held this great country together. I am very, very jealous of this country in spite of its history. I'm very, very jealous of this country because I know at the end of the day, for all its flaws, it is still the greatest country in the world. And so we need to know about it, we need to fight for it, we need to cherish it, and even more importantly, we need to know more about it. It is important that we understand the principles upon which it was founded. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men, they didn't think about us, ladies, are created, that they are endowed by their creator with certain inalienable rights, and that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. God forbid that they know the six principles upon which the Constitution was formed. It is the one thing that every student I taught had to know. We, the people of the United States, in order to form a more perfect union, not perfect, but what? More perfect union. Establish justice, ensure domestic tranquility, provide for the common defense, promote the general welfare, and secure the blessings of liberty, not just to ourselves, but to our posterity. Do ordain and establish this Constitution for the United States of America. What are you saying, Linda? Today, the Constitution is under attack. We don't know, we can't even agree on what truth is anymore in this country. Truth is largely dependent upon the news service that you choose to look or listen to. We used to be able, in my day, to hear what Walter Cronkite had to say and believe that he was telling us the truth. Now our truth comes from Fox, MSNBC, CNN, and none of them can agree on what the truth really is. At the core of the NAACP founding, we knew that the truth was too many people who looked like us were being lynched. We knew at its founding that the fight for equal education was a necessity if we were to succeed as a people. We knew that in order to be able to have an effect on this country, we had to have the right to vote. Those were our truths. Those are still our truths, and we have still got to fight to secure them. Because if we don't, these times, they try our souls will see us lose every little thing that we have gained. It's not the first time. We saw our country torn apart by a civil war. We have seen the ravages of Jim Crow. And today, we see the ravages on our community. While we are watching our children go to school, we worry that they will come home. While we watch our children go to school, we are worried that they have already been engaged with some strangers that may abduct them. While we are watching our children go to school, we know that so many of them are being bullied on the internet. And so we have got to what? Wake up. It's action time. We have got to put our phones down. In my mother's age, we put our foot down. And mama wasn't trying to play with any of us. She had three boys and me. She put her foot down, and when she said it, there was never a but I. We are living in a generation where young people feel that if you tell them something, the response is but I. Ladies and gentlemen, it is time to put our phones down. It is time to put our phones down and make sure that our children can read and arithmetic. It is time to put our feet down so that we know who's on the phone with our children. It is time to put our foot down and invest as much time in making sure our children appreciate the arts as they do sports. When are we going to put our phones down and show our children that good citizens don't just vote when the president is on the ballot, but they vote when school district matters are on the ballot? When do we put our foot down and our phones down and say, you have some chores to do? If they don't learn how to work at home, they're not going to learn how to work. And I'm an old social studies teacher, so if I make anybody mad with this, it's time to put our foot down and our phones down and say, our kids are going to learn how to write their names in cursive. If the computer can write your name in cursive, you are ready to write your name. Imagine going to the bank and chicken scratching your name and trying to get a loan. It is time to put our phones down and demand that every child shall have a full year of instruction in their government. It's time to put our phones down, turn off our version of the news, and engage in a meaningful conversation with our children, our spouse, our neighbor, without resorting to recriminations because we don't happen to agree. This country was based on the principles of compromise. We don't know how to do that anymore. If we say something somebody doesn't like, people get shot. If we say something people don't like, they come to our homes and almost kill our spouses. If we say something people don't like, we storm the capital of the United States. There's something wrong with this, people. This country has been too great for too long. I am a product of segregated schools. There were five names in the books that I received by law, as handed down from the white school to the black school, but we were taught that excuses only satisfy those who make them. And so in spite of all of that, we were able to compete academically when we were called upon to desegregate institutions across this country. Our children can do the same thing. It is unconscionable that in this state, 47% of our children are reading below grade level. It is unconscionable that 43% of our children are doing poorly in math. It is unconscionable that we are not mad as hell and ready to get up and go to school and say, I'm going to volunteer to make things better. That's the role of the NAACP. That's the role of sororities and fraternities. That's the role of the Eastern Star, the Masonic Lodges. We've got to care enough to get involved. Because, ladies and gentlemen, this is indeed a struggle. I was told not to stand up too long, and so I'm going to tell you I'm going to stand up to be seen, speak up to be heard, and sit down to be appreciated. But I leave you with the words of Frederick Douglass, who said very simply, if there is no struggle, there is no progress. Those who profess the faith of freedom, and that's what the NAACP has always stood for, and yet deprecate agitation, want the crops without plowing up the ground. They want the rain without the thunder and the lightning. They want the ocean without the awful roar of its mighty waters. This struggle that we're in may be a moral one, or it may be a physical one, or it may be both moral and physical, but it must be a struggle. Power concedes nothing, nothing, nothing without a demand. It never has. It never will. We may not get all we pay for in this life, but we must certainly pay for all we get. So let us stand together as one. Let us speak together as one. Let us be together as one. Wake up.
People talk about Bill Clinton and Mike Huckabee is from Hope, Arkansas. But when I go places and talk to people, they say, you're from Hope? That's where Senator Chesterfield is from. Because I think it was something about those big watermelons and that water, because she's not the only one from Hope. I mean, I followed in the footsteps of Ben Dennis, who was from Hope. I sat at the footsteps and at the feet of Linda Chesterfield as a child coming up when we had to use those used books. But one thing that we really found out when we came from H.C. Yerga High School was that no one could put limitations on us. The sky was the limit. And if they didn't tell us one thing, they emphasized the fact that you don't have to be great. You just need to do a little bit better than your folks. And if everybody keep on doing a little bit better, then someday we would arrive. So Senator Chesterfield, I have a little something for my homegirl. It says, in the deepest appreciation to Arkansas State Senator Linda Chesterfield, guest speaker at the Greater Texarkana branch of the NAACP Freedom Fund Banquet, this is power. We thank you. We love you. Thank you.
inspired and empowered to move forward with this program tonight. Got a lot of lines coming up. Thank you. As we prepare for tonight's award presentation, please be mindful that each recipient you will see is not just a community leader, but an advocate for equality and inclusion for all people. I would encourage you not to just cheer for the recipients tonight, but seek to get a better understanding of the work that they're doing in their various different agencies. The complete bio of each award recipient is in your program. And also, if other organizations have like gifts for different people that are being recognized, we're asking that happens at the end, at the photo booth in the back right there. There's a photo wall that you can kind of get that done. And also remember that power comes in us collectively working together to advance our community. And so with that being the case, I am going to start us out with the John J. Jones Senior Community Service Award, which represents an individual's benevolent goodwill toward the love of humanity, aid in giving to those in need, providing generosity and helpfulness, especially towards the underprivileged and or suffering, engaged in institutional relief of the underprivileged, and community service. The 2022 John J. Jones Senior Community Service Award recipient is Ms. Mary Hart, Councilwoman Award Number 2. Ms. Hart, Ms. Hart is an Alzheimer's care attendant and nursing assistant. Through countless hours of civil engagement, Ms. Hart has served on the Blue Ribbon Committee, 2C Precinct Chair, Bowie County Deputy Voter Registrar, 2008, 2012, and 2016 Texas State Convention Delegate. She's also a 2012 National Election Judge and an election worker on all levels. Mrs. Hart is most proud of her family, which includes her husband, Oliver, Wendell Hart II, her 5 children, 14 grandchildren, and 10 great grandchildren. That's a lot, yeah. Okay, so President Jones, please receive Ms. Mary Hart, Councilwoman for Ward 2, and the 2022 John J. Jones Senior Award recipient.
Council Lady Hart, your award reads, Greater Texarkana Branch NAACP John J. Jones Senior Community Service Award, recognizing Mary Hart, Councilman Ward 2, in appreciation of your dedication, service to the people of Texarkana, Texas. Presented October the 29th, 2022, Student Arnold Civic Center, Truman Arnold Center, Annual Freedom Fund Banquet, Robert A. Jones, President. Congratulations.
The Dr. Calvin Rolark Business and Economic Award. The Calvin Rolark Business and Economic Award recognizes the progress of individuals who understand that without financial freedom, our gains in civil rights are marginal at best. There are several roads one must take to truly be free. The 2022 Dr. Calvin Rolark Business and Economic Award recipient is Mr. Jonathan Mickey W. Stuart Jr. Mickey Mickey is a native of Texarkana, Arkansas, and received his embalming and funeral director's license from the state of Texas on November 13, 2003, and started working with John J. Jones, Jr. in 2005 as a funeral director and embalmer. Jones Funeral Home, one of Texarkana's historic funeral homes, opened in 2014. In January of 2009, Jones Funeral Homes closed its doors. In 2010, Jonathan acquired and reopened the doors of this historic landmark as Jones Stuart Mortuary, keeping a part of the historic branding intact. Not only was the physical building restored, but a sense of trust and pride in the community was reestablished under Jonathan's ownership. Jones Stuart Mortuary is a vibrant part of the community, providing employment for more than a dozen individuals and serving hundreds of families with compassion, dignity, excellence in service, and professionalism. Jonathan is a member of the Masonic Order. If asked why he serves with such passion, he'll respond with a big smile. I was placed here by God to serve. Additionally, I have a comment that was submitted by Mr. Alvin Hamilton. And I'll just read some of it to you. It says, he is such a humble fellow. I'm a better owner, friend, and funeral professional because of having the opportunity to be around him. I was working for Smith in the building, and I purchased and ended up doing my embalming and having the opportunity to see what Wright looked like in this building. He is truly one of my dear friends for life. Mr. Alvin Hamilton is there, and this is Mr. Mickey Jonathan Stewart, Mr. Jones, the 2022 Dr. Calvin Rolark Business and Economic Award recipient.
Not for you. I, Greater Texarkana Branch of the NAACP, Dr. Calvin Rolark Business and Economic Award, presented to Jonathan Mickey William Stewart Jr. in recognition of your remarkable dedication to the Texarkana community. Compassion is the greatest form of love humans have to offer. R. Scott, presented October the 29th, 2022, Annual Freedom Fund Awards Banquet, Robert A. Jones, President.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Dr. Taker, and you know, we don't tend to say too much. I told a lie, didn't I? First, give it unto God, who has made all of this possible, to the greater NAACP, for nominating me for this award. We go through life all the time, just doing what we do in our profession, never looking for recognition, but I always say, even to my people, be on your best behavior at all times. You never know who's watching you. You go to the grocery store, you go to the park, or even just walking out your front door. Be on your best behavior, because somebody gonna tell you. I'm so happy to see my best friend, Alvis Hamilton, over there. Thank you for coming, man. My staff sit back there in the corner. I must say, without you all, there is no me. I can't do this by myself. And people, y'all, take heed. The people that walk beside you, appreciate them to the utmost. You can't do it alone. You gotta have help in everything that you do. But I said I wasn't going to talk too long. But I just want to say to this community that I am here every day, 24/7, 365. My phone doesn't go off. Even after the funerals are over, I still tend to reach out to the people that I have served. You're not just a client. You are a friend indeed. You have become my family once you come through my office door. I love you. I will never treat you like you are nothing. Everybody is on the same playing field. I'm not bigger than you, you're not bigger than me. We're gonna sit there, we're gonna laugh, and have a good time. Yeah, I know you're grieving, but when you come in my door, I want you to leave out of there with your head high, knowing that John Stuart Mortuary is gonna keep you on top. Mr. Jones, Ms. Miller, God bless you all. Good night.
Alton and Mott Mosley both were prolific educators and community leaders in the Texarkana area. They inspired dreams and helped thousands reach their full potential. In their honor, the NAACP recognizes community leaders who work in the field of education. The 2022 A.E. Alton Educational Award recipient is Dr. Gina Bullock. Since 2004, Dr. Bullock has served as the Director of Public Relations in the Texarkana, Arkansas School District. Additionally, Dr. Bullock is an adjunct professor at Texas A&M University, Texarkana. Her ability to easily transcend cultural differences led her to being selected to spearhead the school district's journey toward becoming a culturally proficient school system. Through her leadership, innovation, and strategic thinking, she increased employee, parental, and community involvement within the district. Gina believes that it's important to be the change you want to see in the community. And thus, she's active in Texas A&M University Texarkana Alumni Board, the NAACP of Miller County, Leadership Texarkana, Junior League of Texarkana, Texarkana Chamber of Commerce, Wilbur Smith Rotary Club, and is a part of the Texarkana Regional Arts and Humanities Council, serving on the African American Committee. President Jones, please receive Dr. Gina Bullock, the 2022 A.E. Alton Educational Award recipient.
Dr. Bullock, the Greater Texarkana branch of the NAACP A.E. Alton Education Award, presented to Dr. Gina Bullock in recognition of your outstanding professionalism, high expectation, and leadership. You have made a significant impact on the lives of young people in your school district and community. Presented October the 29th, 2022 at the annual Freedom Fund Awards Banquet. Robert A. Jones, President.
Good evening, everyone. First, I would like to say congratulations to all of the honorees here tonight and to say thank you for the work you do in and around our community. I would also like to thank the NAACP for this award, but more importantly, I'd like to thank the NAACP of Greater Texarkana for ensuring to uphold your mission to ensure the prosperity and opportunities and advancement for all people. The NAACP is relevant, it is far-reaching, and it's more important today than it's ever been before. So we appreciate the work that the NAACP of the greater Texarkana area, we appreciate what you're doing. So thank you so much for this award. Again, congratulations to all the honorees, and thank you.
Designed to recognize a member of the clergy who demonstrates passion for fighting for justice and equality through their ministry. The civil rights movement was successful primarily because of the courageousness of our churches. The 2022 Religious Affairs Award recipient is Reverend Howard Knight, Jr. Reverend Knight is the founding pastor of Grace Community and World Outreach Christian Center Church and accepted his call to preach at the age of 28. He was ordained and licensed to preach at the age of 29 in the denominational church and was called to pastor his first church 6 months later. Reverend Knight recently retired after 37 years of civil service with the U.S. Department of the Army. He's a member of the Alpha excuse me, ooh. Whoa. He's a member of Omega Psi Phi Fraternity Incorporated. Let's call Stephen Gass so I can get out tonight. All right, I definitely apologize. Let me read that again. He's a member of the Omega Psi Phi Fraternity Incorporated, the Association of Independent Ministers International, a lifetime member of the NAACP, and a real estate investor. Reverend Knight serves his community in various capacities, including junior achievement volunteer in the public school system, a school crisis response counselor, Liberty Isle School District Improvement Committee member, and the Liberty Isle Fellowship of Pastors. Reverend Dr. Ruffin, please receive Reverend Howard Knight Jr., the 2022 Religious Affairs Award recipient. In appreciation of your faithful and dedicated service to our religious community, your ministry has made a difference in so many lives. Therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, stand firm. Let nothing move you. Always give yourself fully to the work of the Lord, because you know that your labor in the Lord is not in vain. 1 Corinthians 15:58, presented October 29, 2022, Annual Freedom Fund Awards Banquet, Robert A. Jones, President. Others. The 2022 Dan Haskins Torchbearer Award recipient is Mrs. LaTonya McElroy. Mrs. McElroy is the author of the book Workforce Champion, Breaking Through, a full-time corporate chief of people officer, and an inspiring, inspirational speaker whose goal is to build a global platform to attract those who want to take their career to the next level. From struggling as a suddenly single mom on state assistance with three part-time jobs to a thriving professional in her field with the highest industry designations available, LaTonya's story is a rags to not quite riches story. LaTonya has recently partnered with Literacy Council nonprofit organizations that empowers families in crisis through literacy, education, and life resources. Why the literacy programs? It's because LaTonya will never forget her darkest places, and meeting these families gives her the chance to shine in the light of hope and transformation. Here's one of her other messages of life. When you think you're buried, you're not. You're planted, and what's next is up to you. President Jones, please receive Mrs. LaTonya McElroy, the 2022 Dan Haskins Torchbearer Award recipient.
LaTonya. It's thanks the Greater Texarkana Branch of the NAACP Dan Haskins Torchbearer Award, presented to LaTonya McElroy in appreciation for your outstanding and exceptional work in inspiring others and eliminating barriers in human resource management. Given this October the 29th, 2022, at the annual Freedom Fund Awards Banquet, Robert Jones, President.
Good evening to the Greater Texarkana NAACP Board, to you, to all who planned this event, and to all of our members here, and to all of you honorees and attendees. I want to say thank you for honoring me with the award tonight. When Ms. Melva messaged me, I was like, no, you got the wrong number, because I really did. I said, are you sure? I didn't respond, and then I asked her, are you sure this is for me? And so I just want to say how much I'm honored, because when I hear the name Dan Haskins, he's a legacy to me. He's a legacy. And I go, why me? And I think about how he did so many things. My mom used to say Coach Haskins, and then I realized he became a principal in probably the most difficult time in public schools, when the schools were integrated, and he started out at Dunbar Elementary and ended up as a principal. And then he was one of the first African-American superintendents. So with all that he did and all he inspired, it just gives me more of a challenge, I'll say that, because I'm a little bit of a lot of people in this room. As I was greeting people when I came in today, I saw so many people who have inspired me from all the way down when I was born and up until today, and still are inspiring me. Like, I already cried twice today because someone said something that touched my heart, because these are the people in this room who have shone their light in my life. And I just would like for you to just a moment, imagine Texarkana. Somebody said, oh, that's strategic doing. I know what she's doing. Yes. Imagine Texarkana being such a bright place in this world that everyone on the planet knew who Texarkana was. I believe that's possible when our children receive a quality education, when we inspire them to reach their goals. And all of us in the room, I want to encourage you, because this award tonight encourages me to continue to shine your light, tell your story. People need to hear your story, because your story inspires. And I would like for you as an NAACP in our area to know that it's so much appreciated that you continue to hold up your torch. Thank you so much tonight.
When you get down front, I need you to stop out in front, because your little honey pie got something for you down there.
Shirley Finn Trailblazwer Award, which recognizes an innovative individual who has made their mark in education, the community, and leadership, therefore paving the way for others. The 2022 Dr. Shirley Finn Trailblazer Award recipient is Mrs. Cynthia Tyous. Ms. Tyous is a native of Texarkana and has a passion for volunteering in the community with our youth. Spearheading the Unity in the Community Backpack Drive and facilitating youth workshops, Ms. Tyous encourages our youth to soar in life. Cynthia has a love in life for writing and has published two children's books, Can Pink Elephants Fly and God's Closet. Both books, by the way, are available on Amazon and Barnes & Noble. A member of Lone Oak Baptist Church Texarkana, Ms. Tyous is Vice President of the Youth Department, Vice President of the Girls Ministry, and helps facilitate classes with the Southwest District Association of Arkansas. a board member with the Catherine Burton Know Your Worth Scholarship Committee, the most important aspect about Ms. Tyous is that she takes every opportunity to soar to greater heights. President Jones, please receive Ms. Cynthia Tyous, the 2022 Dr. Shirley Finn Trailblazer Award recipient.
Greater Texarkana branch of the NAACP, Dr. Shirley Finn Trailblazer Award, presented to Cynthia Tyous in recognition of outstanding achievement and impact to the community, working with youth and being a twice published children book author, given October 29, 2022, at the annual Freedom Fund Awards Banquet. Robert A. Jones, President. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. It was an honor to receive the call from Ms. Melva for the Dr. Shirley Finn Trailblazer Award. I would be remiss to say, NAACP, you're doing a marvelous job. I want to recognize the people that pushed me the hardest in the community. My family, please stand. My Lono family, please stand. My scholars family, please stand. JC Empowerment, please stand. These are the people that are behind me, that push me the hardest. I want to say thank you for always being there for me. In the community, I look at two things, passion and purpose. My passion is love of the young people, but my purpose is ministry. If you're not reaching your young people, then what are you doing? As an author, I want to share this with you. They recognize me as a trailblazer. As a trailblazer, you illuminate the mind. As a trailblazer, you rejuvenate a person's body. As a trailblazer, you restore someone's vision. As a trailblazer, you clap for everyone's effort. As a trailblazer, you rally for your community. As a trailblazer, you provide resources to everyone to educate. As a trailblazer, you celebrate everyone's win. I just want to say thank you. It was an honor to receive Dr. Shirley Finn, the Trailblazer Award. I want you to know that one person is power, but as a group, we are powerful. Thank you.
Achievement Award is for outstanding vision, dedication, and commitment to the community and the various contributions during the course of your life and your profession. The 2022 Lifetime Achievement Award recipient is Ms. Essie Dodd. Ms. Dodd is a mother, mother-in-law, grandmother, and great-grandmother. Career and community involvement for Ms. Dodd started as an elementary school educator in the Texarkana Independent School District during the segregated era. She became one of the first two African-American teachers to pioneer integration in the schools in Texarkana. Although Ms. Dodd's 32-year of dedicated service at TISD was beneficial and rewarding to service to the community, she always found and continues to find her Christian life to be most rewarding in every way. Ms. Dodd has never outgrown being asked her ideas and execution of activities where the expectations anticipated are successful outcomes. An active member with the National Women's Missionary Council of the Christian Methodist Episcopal Church, Zeta Phi Beta Sorority Incorporated Gamma Kappa Zeta Chapter, the NAACP, Las Amigas, Alasanigas, Civic and Social Club, and the Texas Retired Teachers Association, Mrs. Dodd is humbled and honored to be celebrated at this occasion. Mr. Jones, please receive Ms. Essie Dodd, the 2022 Lifetime Achievement Award recipient.
Mrs. Dodd, the Greater Texarkana Branch of the NAACP Lifetime Achievement Award is presented to Mrs. Essie Dodd, award for many years of outstanding leadership, vision, and dedication to the Texarkana community, presented October the 29th, 2022, at the annual Freedom Fund Awards ranking. Robert A. Jones, President. Congratulations.
The president of the NAACP local chapter in Texarkana, and to Mrs. Flowers, who is responsible for submitting my name for this honor tonight. I would just like to say thank you for this honor, and it is a great honor for me. And it almost came too late because it's not too many more years that I got y'all. Two more years and I'll be, I don't know. But anyway, thank God I'm still here. I'm so happy to be here tonight and to see your faces. You know, COVID was not so bad other than you had to stay away from your friends, stay at home and take everything on this new stuff that I don't know a lot about. Y'all know I really did enjoy the message from the messenger tonight. She took us back a little bit, and that was wonderful for me, because I would like to see children learn how to write their names. I would like to recognize tonight, Mr. Jones, if it's not intimidating on anybody. And I don't care if I'm intimidating on anybody. You know, I'm the last one. I'm the oldest one. I can say what I want to say. Thank y'all for coming out. Thank y'all for making this possible. Thank you, Jenny. And then on my sorority family, I have a special guest over there tonight that I would like to indulge in a time and ask you to let my president present her. You know, they love me. They come from all over the state to see me tonight. Today is the 29th. In two more months, on the 29th, I will be 99.
Director.
is the Benjamin Dennis President's Award. The Benjamin Dennis President's Award is the most coveted award at the Freedom Fund Awards Banquet. Honorees must exemplify and live free to the NAACP. The grant's president is responsible for recognizing someone from the community to bestow this prestigious honor upon. The 2022 Benjamin Dennis President's Award recipient is Mrs. Melva Flowers. Mrs. Flowers is currently employed by Texarkana College, where she's an adjunct instructor and student retention advisor. She served 20 years of service with the local Social Security Administration. As board chair for the Housing Authority of Texarkana, Texas, better known as HAT, and its affiliate corporations, Ms. Flowers has successfully developed and advocated for financial, political, and community support. She oversees the largest provider of affordable housing in Boone County, with total assets of over $38 million, with an over $18 million annual operating budget. Mrs. Flowers was instrumental in the Housing Authority's transformation from its traditional public housing model to rental assistance demonstration. With a passion for helping people and making the community a better place to live, Ms. Flowers serves on numerous amounts of committees, including the Alzheimer's Alliance, International Rotary Club, TISD Diversity Committee, TISD Foundation, and is a life member of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated. Member of Las Amigas Social and Civic Club of Texarkana, Texas, life member of the NAACP, Texarkana Resource Center, Northeast Texas Alliance of Black School Educators member, Four States Youth Flyer Club, charter member and president of the Newtown Neighborhood Association, Panhellenic Council, the Salvation Army, a charter member of the Twin City Black History Association, CASA, the American Cancer Society, Mabel Morris Women's Center, and the Domestic Violence Prevention Center. Ms. Flowers stays busy and is very involved. Mr. Jones, please receive Ms. Melva Flowers, the 2022 Benjamin Dennis President Award recipient.
You know, after last year's banquet, we list all of our past awardees. After a banquet, somebody came up to me and tapped me on the shoulder. They said, Mr. Jones. I said, what? I see everybody's name in this book, even yours. Why don't I see Miss Flowers? I said, she not in there? They said, she's been recognized by every organization in this town, except the one that she's given over 20-something years planning and organizing a banquet. They said, how can y'all overlook it? I said, you know what? We gonna fix this. And so, this year, the President Award is going to none other than one of the hardest working ladies for the NAACP. She even handles our complaint line, and it rains 1,000 times a day. But it states, the Greater Texarkana Branch Benjamin Dennis President Award presented to Melva Hildred Flowers. Thank you for your outstanding, exemplary community service, leadership, dedication, and commitment to the NAACP, serving as Freedom Fund Award Banquet Chair for 25 years. October the 29th, 2022, Annual Freedom Fund Awards Banquet, Robert A. Jones, President. Congratulations. Finally.
Present the awards to people in our community. So for several weeks as we were planning the NAACP banquet, I said, Stubbs, who are we going to get a president's award to? I don't know. I said, Stubbs, who are we going to get a president's award to? I'll think about it. I'll let you know. This went on and on. I decided I wasn't going to ask them anymore. So one night we were having a committee meeting by Zoom, and somebody came to my door. And so I said, you all have to excuse me, someone is at my door. So I went to the door to take care of somebody coming to pick up a scholarship check. So when I came back, they said, you're gonna get the President's Award. So I could not believe that they had planned this and nobody had not told me that I was receiving the award. But I'm humbled to accept the award. I've been doing the chairperson for the banquet for over 25 years, as they have said. But I could not do it without the people that have supported the NAACP and the branch in itself, and Sears, and my sister Ruby, and I work with Mr. Dennis, and I work with anybody that came through and left and came back again, or whatever. I've still been there. But I just want to recognize my family. They're here to support me. My sorority sisters who are here, members of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority. If you're not standing, would you stand now? All my sorors, I am so happy to see you all. Mr. Williams, who is the CEO for the Housing Authority, he always supports me. In fact, Mr. Williams, Mr. Jones always tell me, you're my boss. He always remind me. He said, you know, Mr. Williams is your boss. I said, okay. I thought the chairperson in the board was Mr. Williams. I said, Mr. Williams, you're a boss. So, Mr. Williams, I get a new title. You get a new title. But anyway, thank you all so much. I love the work of the NAACP. I love what I do. I love when it comes time to give awards and looking out in the community. There's so many amazing people doing so many amazing things, and it is one of the things that fills my heart with joy to be able to recognize you and to see those smiles on your face as you get the award. As I say, I feel real awkward standing up here accepting this award. But I do accept this award, and I accept this award along with my two sisters and my daughter that's here tonight in honor of my mother and my father. They stress the importance of giving back to your community and looking out for other people. That my dad, it was so funny, on Christmas, my dad would always tell my mom to get some socks and some handkerchiefs and little gifts and put them in the Christmas tree. So if anybody came by, they always left with a Christmas present. That was one of the things that he believed in so much at Christmas time. And my mom, up until she was 82 or 83 years old, she volunteered at the Friendship Center. She loved doing what she's doing, what she was doing, and she emphasized that. And so I accept this award along with my sisters in honor of my mother and my father. It's been 2018 since my mom attended a Freedom Fund banquet. She never missed one of them. So again, thank you all so much. Thank you, and I cannot say that this banquet would not be successful without you all. Some of you all have been here every year that we've had this banquet. So again, thank you so much for all you do for the community, all that you do for the Greater Texarkana branch of the NAACP. We thank you, thank you, thank you. And if you want to do something very, very special for me, go out and vote if you have not voted. Thank you.
Can we put our hands together for all of the award recipients tonight? Amazing. All right, Mr. Johnson, you're back up. Oh, no, you're not doing it. Okay, all right. You're back.
I thought I was going to get a minute to get my proposal down. But I think after the vote, you recognize our sponsor. Mr. Jones is up. He's going to do the elected officials and then I'll come back.
All right. Well, all the elected officials, please stand. I'm not going to follow in that track. Everyone that's elected, please stand. We have school board members, city council members, all kinds of folks out here. And didn't nobody give me a night, they name, so everybody give them a round of applause. And we thank y'all so very, very much for being here. Thank you. Was that enough time?
Okay, so we do want to thank our sponsors, and I also have one of my church members here who was my former First Lady, Sister Nye Glover. Thank you. She always supports me in whatever I'm doing. So thank you again, Ms. Glover, for being here. I forgot to thank her. And if I fail to thank somebody else, thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay, so we are up to our sponsorship. The Greater Texarkana branch of the NAACP would like to extend a special thanks to the following corporate sponsors who not only assist us with making this event special, but also for providing opportunities and supporting the community throughout the year. Some of our sponsors, we always know that they're going to sponsor us every year. Our first sponsor, the Housing Authority, Mr. Williams, our CEO for the Greater Texarkana Housing Authority, and that name has changed to Village Community. So if you ride down Robinson Road, you see Village Community, that is the Housing Authority. We're in the process of rebranding, so we provide the same service, same people, with a new name. Texarkana College, Dr. Smith, thank you so much for allowing us to use this beautiful facility to be here today. We always, always know that you're going to support us. So we appreciate you and Texarkana College. Also, board member, Mr. George Moore. Our golden sponsorship is Christian St. Michael Hospital. We have Ms. Ray Thickpen, who is representing St. Michael's. Would you raise your hand, Ms. Thickpen? Thank you. Domtar, do we have anyone here from Domtar? Thank you so much. Farmers Bank and Trust, Mr. James Bramlett is the president for Farmers Bank. State Farm Insurance, the picture on the wall, Mr. Derrick McGary. Would you stand? There he is. All right. Thank you. Texas A&M University, Texarkana. We have that table right in front of me. Would you all please raise your hand? Let us know who you are. Thank you so much. Also, my sister Catherine is employed with Texas A&M University. Our bronze sponsorship, KTOR 104.7. All right, thank you. Didi's here. Didi's my cousin. I always like to tell people she's my cousin. Thank you, Didi, for always putting it up. Panelist Council. The Panelist Council consists of the Greek organizations, the seven Greek organizations that make up the Panelist Council in Texarkana. If you're a member of the Panelist Council, would you please stand? We need to see our group. Please join me in giving them a round of applause. Reverend Federal Credit Union. Have anyone for Reverend Credit Union? Tax America. Did you raise one? Thank you, Bob. Mayor Boogerman. I won't just call you Bob. I call you Bob so much. But we appreciate you being here. Tax America. Mr. Norton called and said that he would not be able to come tonight, but he usually is here to support us. Texarkana Emergency Center and Hospital. They have been supporting us for the last 2 or 3 years. These are our sponsors. If your name is not appeared in our book as a sponsor, we do invite you for next year to become a sponsor for the Greater Texarkana branch. We need the funds, as Mr. Jones said, that this is the only fundraiser that we really have is through our Freedom Fund database. Thank you again to all of our sponsors. We appreciate you, and I encourage you to do business with us. Oh. Mr. Jones wants me to always, and we always forget this one organization who is a part of Texarkana College, the Black Student Association. They work, they pay first, then they work. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. And we've already recognized our top team. And do we have the scholars here? We don't have any youth here. We just have their sponsors here. So we just want to make sure that we recognize our youth. I'm going to give this microphone to Mr. Jones. He's going to recognize all these people that I have not recognized. So again, thank you all so much for all that you've done for this NAACP.
Well, since she got time. If you're not aware of the fact, we were broadcasting live on YouTube and Facebook, and we want to thank our production engineers over there. All right, Harry. We got Harry, we got Chad. I mean, Anybody else over there working with y'all, they're doing a great job. We want to thank Chuck Wack. Give it up for Chuck Wack. This was the first time they had ventured into this. They said it's new ground, but they're going to get out here and do their best. And like I said, y'all pulling it off, all right. We'll be looking, other folks going to be looking to contact you, so start getting ready. But once again, but we really need to thank you. You are the one who put the energy and the drive into the NAACP. And without you, there would be no NAACP. We want to thank you, thank you, thank you. And let's give it up, y'all. Our MC. I didn't even know he was going to do a video. I saw that, I said, what's wrong? He did a video. I said, well, all right. That was, you know, you may have to do this again. We don't know no one else that can do a video. All right, well, we want to thank you, thank you, thank you. And so I'm going to give it to him one more time as he gives his closing remarks and turn it over to Reverend Ruff.
Thank you, Mr. Jones. Just a point of, I guess, preference, I guess I have. Next week, the National Alliance, the Northeast Texas Alliance of Black School Educators, we're having our fourth annual administrative symposium. And so if you'd like more information about that, definitely go to our website at www.netabse.org. And that's one of our educational organizations that we have here in Texarkana, where I do serve as president as well. So I just wanted to kind of give that good information for you to keep and have. While our journey is coming to an end, our power must remain at the forefront of all we do. Whitney M. Young, an American civil rights leader, once said, "Black power simply means, look at me, I'm here. I have dignity, I have pride, I have roots. I insist, I demand that I participate in those decisions that affect my life and the lives of my children. It means that I am somebody." And so because we are somebody, please make sure, again, that you're going out to vote in this year's election and all of the elections and allowing your voice to be heard. Additionally, the Greater Texarkana branch of the NAACP is always looking for new members. And so I know they have information downstairs and also upstairs if you are not a member and you would like to join. It is my sincere hope that when you leave tonight, you are inspired to renew your commitment to service, integrity, and transparency to not just this community, but to our country and to our world. And so without any further ado,
we need all of the awardees to say, well, group
picture.
And any other picture.
Okay.
Awardees can't leave, everybody else.
You want them to say again? Okay. So all the awardees just stay kind of in here and we'll kind of get some picture shots of you and Mr. Jones and Ms. Flowers and everybody else. So
it's been nice, hasn't it?
Yeah. Cool. I'm going to go home and check on Simba, who's probably sitting by the door because he's not ready to go out to the bathroom because he ate 5 hours ago. But God bless his soul. He's like 68, but he acts like he's 30, so bless my dog. Bless him. And he needs to lose weight, too. So anyhow, Reverend Dr. Ruffin, it is your time to close us out.
Stand with me, if you would, please. Father God, may your grace and your mercy be with us as we prepare to leave this place, but never leave your presence. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.